is our God, always and ever, and to his pages.
Amen. Glory to thee, our God, glory to thee, O heavenly King, the Comforter, the Spirit of Truth, who art everywhere present and through us all things. Treasury of good gifts and giver of life, come and abide in us and cleanse us of all impurity and save our souls, O good one. Holy God, holy my people, more than my mercy on us. Holy God, holy my people, more than my mercy on us. Holy God, holy my people, more than my mercy on us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. O most holy Trinity, have mercy on us, O Lord God, our sins, O Master, pardon our iniquities, O Holy One, visit and heal our infirmities, for thy name's sake. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one.
Thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen. Lord, have mercy, 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 Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. O come, let us worship God, our King. Come, let us worship and fall down before Christ, our King and God. O come, let us worship and fall down before Christ himself, our King and our God. Hearken, O Lord, unto my righteousness, and attend unto my supplication, and give ear unto the prayer. Unto my prayer which cometh not from deceitful lips, from before thy face, let my judgment come forth, let mine eyes behold the brightness. Thou hast proved my heart, thou hast visited it in the night. Thou hast tried me by fire, and then righteousness was not found in me. That my mouth might not speak of the words of men, for the sake of the words of thy lips have I kept the ways that are hard. Set my footsteps in thy paths, that my steps may not be shaken. I am proud, for thou hast hearkened unto me, O God. Incline thine ear unto me, and hearken unto my words. Let thy mercy be made wonderful, O thou that savest them that hope in thee. From them that have resisted thy right hand, keep me, O Lord, as the apple of thine eye. In the shelter of thy wings wilt thou shelter me, in the face of the ungodly, and trust me. My enemies have surrounded my soul, they have enclosed themselves with their own fat, their mouth hath spoken pride. They that cast me out have now encircled me, they have set their eyes. your blood, glory to thy resurrection, O Christ. Glory to thy kingdom, glory to thy dispensation, O thou who lovest mankind. Glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Great are the accomplishments of faith for the three holy youths. Rejoice in the fountain of flames as though the waters of rest. And the prophet Daniel appeared a shepherd to the lions as though they were sheep. So by the prayers of Christ God, save our souls, both now and ever, and through the ages of ages. Amen. O thou, Tobost, thou art the true vine that hath blossomed forth for us the fruit of life. Thee do we supplicate, intercede, O Lady, together with the holy apostles, that our souls find mercy. Blessed is the Lord God, blessed is the Lord, day by day, the God of our salvation, who hath brought for us along the way. Our God is the God of salvation. Holy God, holy mighty, holy mark, love mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy mark, love mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy mark, love mercy on us. Glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and in the ages of ages. Amen. O most holy Mary, have mercy on us, O Lord, blot out our sins. O Master, pardon our iniquities, O Holy One, visit me on our iniquities today. Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and in the ages of ages. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one.
Thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and ever, unto the ages of ages.
Amen. You did not worship the graven image of Christ's blessed ones, but armed with the immaterial essence of God, you were glorified in the trial by fire. From the midst of unbearable flame, you fall on God, crying, hasten, O compassionate one, speedily come to our aid, for thou art merciful and able to do as thou wast willed. Lord have mercy, 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 Lord have mercy. out of thee, under whose wing shalt thou have hope. With the shield will the truth be prophesied, thou shalt not be afraid of the terror by night, nor for the arrow that flieth by day, nor for the thing that walketh in darkness, nor for the mishap of the even of noonday. A thousand shall fall at thy side, and 10,000 at thy right hand, but thy feet shall not be broken. Only with thine eye shalt thou behold, and thou shalt see the reward of sinners. But thou, O Lord, art my hope. Thou madest the Most High thy refuge, and the people shall come nigh thee, and those first shall draw nigh for thy dwelling. For each will give his angels charge over thee in all thy ways. On their hands shall they bear thee up, lest at any time thou dash thy foot against the stone. Upon the ass and the basilisk shalt thou tread, and thou shalt trample upon the lion and the dragon. For he hath set his hope on me, and I will honor him, because he hath known my name. He shall cry unto me, and I will hearken unto him. I am with him in affliction, and I will rescue him, and glorify him. The length of days will I satisfy him, and I will show him my salvation.
Morning, Fortini.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Alleluia, 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 glory to thee, O God. Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy. When the stone had been sealed by the Jews, while the soldiers were guarding him on your body, thou didst rise on the third day, O Savior, and granted life to the world. The powers of heaven therefore cry to thee,
Lord of
life, glory to thy resurrection, O Christ, glory to thy kingdom, glory to thy dispensation, O thou who lovest mankind, glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Greater the accomplishments of faith than the three holy youths rejoice in the fountain of flames as though in the waters of rest, and the prophet Daniel appeared a shepherd to the lions as though they were sheep. So by the prayers of Christ God, save our souls. Both now and ever, and the ages of ages, amen. Seeing that we have no boldness on account of our many sins, do thou beseech him that was born of thee, O Virgin Theotokos, for the supplication of a mother availeth much to win the master's favor. Disdain not the prayers of sinners, who all fear with merciful and mighty to save us. He deigned also to suffer for our sake. Let thy compassions quickly be for us, O Lord, for we are become exceedingly poor. Help us, O God, our Savior, for the sake of the glory of thy name, O Lord, who the rest of the gracious and our sins for thy name's sake. Holy God, holy mighty, holy merciful, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy merciful, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy merciful, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. O most holy Trinity, have mercy on us, O Lord, wipe away our sins. O Master, pardon our transgressions, O Holy One, who is healing our infirmities for thy name's sake. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one.
Thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and for ages, ages.
Amen. You did not worship the graven image of thrice blessed ones, but armed with the immaterial essence of God, you were glorified in the trial by fire. From the midst of unbearable flames, you called on God, crying, hasten, O compassionate ones, speedily come to our aid, for thou art merciful and able to do as thou dost will. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, to be in his image, amen. More honorable than the cherubim, and the uncomparable glory of the seraphim, and who without corrupting means birth to God the Word, and the very tales of which you have magnified. In the name of the Lord, Father, and Father.
Holy Father, glory to the skies, the Lord, which we honor.
Amen. The God and Lord of hosts, and Maker of all creation, who by the tender compassion of thy mercy, who transcendent comprehension, who sent down thy only begotten Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, for the salvation of our race, and by his precious cross, which stares under the handwriting of our sins, and thereby does triumph over the principalities and powers of darkness. Be thou thyself, O compassion for the over of mankind, accept also from us sinners these prayers of thanksgiving and entreaty, and deliverance from every destructive and dark transgression, and from all enemies, both visible and invisible, that seek to do us evil. Nail down our flesh with the fear of thee, and incline not our hearts and words with God's people, but pay our souls.
So
God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Come and reign, most holy, most pure, most blessed and glorious, Dei Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints. Let us commend ourselves and each other and all our life unto Christ our God.
Lord, have mercy.
and that they told to everyone who I know from the Lord. And Abraham done rejoiced for the seed, but he reported not of years. By the word of God, who is God, who is proclaimed for the walking, has turned himself to be a man.
to thy spirit.
Wisdom.
The proclamation and the foretold. Blessed art thou, O Lord God of our fathers, and praised and glorified is thy name forever.
Blessed art thou, O Lord God.
And all that thou hast done for us.
Blessed art thou, O Lord God of our fathers, and wisdom glorified is thy name forever.
Blessed art thou, O Lord God of our fathers. From the epistle of the Holy Apostle Paul to the Hebrews. Brethren, by faith Abraham obeyed him, he was called out unto the place which he would afterward receive an inheritance, and he went out not knowing where he went. By faith he sojourned in the land of the promise, as in a strange country dwelling, in tents with Isaac and Jacob, the heirs with him of the same promise. For he looked for the city which has foundations, and whose builder and maker is God. By faith Abraham, when he was tested, offered up Isaac, and he who had received the promises offered up his only begotten son, of which it was said, In Isaac shall thy seed be called. According that God was able to raise him up even from the dead, so to say, from which he also received him. By faith Isaac blessed Jacob and Esau concerning things to come. By faith Jacob, when he was dying, blessed both sons of Joseph and worshipped leaning upon the top of his staff. By faith Joseph, when he was dying, made mention of the departure of the children of Israel, and gave instructions concerning his bones. By faith Moses, when he was born, was hidden 3 months by his parents, because they saw he was a beautiful child, and they were not afraid of the king's commandment. And what more shall I say? For the time would fail me to tell of Gideon and of Barak and of Samson and Jephthah, also of David and Samuel and the other prophets, who through faith subdued kingdoms, worked righteousness, obtained promises, stopped the mouths of lions, quenched the violence of fire, escaped the edge of the sword, out of weaknesses were made strong, became valiant in battle, turned to flight the armies of the enemies. Women received their dead raised again, raised to life again, and others were tortured, not accepting deliverance, that they might obtain a better resurrection. Still others had a trial of cruel mockings and scourgings, yes, and of chance and imprisonment. They were stoned, they were sawn asunder, were tempted and were slain by the sword. They wandered about in sheepskins and goatskins, being destitute, afflicted, tormented, of whom the world was not worthy. They wandered in deserts and mountains and in dens and caves of the earth. And all of these, having obtained a good report through faith, did not receive the promise, God having provided something better for us, that apart from us they should not be made perfect. And to your spirit,
wisdom.
In the fourth tone, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
prophets have told us.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
For thou hast saved us from them that oppose us, and hast put to shame those that hate us.
Alleluia.
Fulfilled, which was spoken by the Lord through the prophet, saying,
Behold, the virgin shall be with child and bear a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel, which is translated God with us. And Joseph, being aroused from sleep, did as the angel of the Lord commanded him, and took to him his wife, and did not know her until she brought forth her firstborn son, and he called his name Jesus.
Yeshua, the son of Nun, to lead them into the promised land.
This is fulfilled in a deeper sense today. The law prepared the people to receive the Messiah. But it's Jesus Christ, who comes as the true Savior, who delivers us not from the slavery in a foreign country, but from the slavery of sin and death and corruption, and gives us true freedom and purity and life in the Holy Spirit. Not just life here and now, but in making our genealogy his own, he makes it possible for us to share his divine life, becoming children of God by grace and adoption. The second name, Emmanuel, proclaims that God is with us. God is with us, the sign foretold by the prophet Isaiah. Behold, the virgin shall be with child. The virgin shall bear a child, and they shall call his name Emmanuel, which being translated means God with us. And God is with us, not in just the sense of moral support or as an abstract presence, but in a real and immediate way. He has taken on all of human nature, joined us to himself, making it possible for him to dwell and abide in us, and we in him. As we reflect on today's reading, we have to realize that all of us have a mixed genealogy, so to speak. We're a mixed bag. If we go back in all of our own family trees, sometimes just a generation or two, we might find a saint. Say with especially a very special baptizing of baby Anna recently, whose patron saint was, I believe, her great aunt, Anna Borovskaya, the new martyr. Many of us can find, perhaps not a canonized saint, but saintly people in our family tree. We also might find those who served hard time and not for noble reasons. We've got it all there. We're all the inheritors and recipients of both the good and the virtuous in our past, as well as the psychological and emotional baggage, and sometimes predisposition to certain sins and vices. But given all of this, we have to understand that we have the freedom in Christ to choose to embrace what is good and holy, if we want to, or to let ourselves be defined by the opposite. Jesus gives us the greatest possible freedom in this. We can follow the examples of our holy forefathers, like Abraham and David, or we can sink down into the mire, like those who prefer not to remember, like Rehoboam and Jehoram, the wicked kings of Israel who did not walk in the ways of their fathers and selfishly lived and worshipped false gods. It's our choice. St. John Chrysostom would sometimes remind his congregation, saying that even if you have a saint in your family tree, a holy martyr, it won't do you any good unless you follow their example and way of life. We have to choose to follow that way of life. Now, all of us are here, I venture to say, because we have someone in our life praying for us, whether still on this earth or now in the kingdom. At times in all of our lives, we think about this. I would suggest to really reflect on this later today, perhaps. At times in our life, we really sense this in a deep and real way. Someone praying for us. We've experienced being saved from going down a bad path. We've found our way back to God only through his grace and through the prayers of other people, known or unknown in our lives. And I have to say, too, that one of the most shameful and saddening tendencies of our times is for family members to cut each other off over various offenses and political or other disagreements. The Son of God became the Son of Man for this very reason, to reconcile fallen humanity with himself, with God. This Christmas, let's all take the risk and seek out reconciliation in our families. Let's take a step back and reflect. Do we really want the next time that we see or talk to that uncle or cousin or friend or even parent to be at their funeral? At that time, we'll always find ourselves saying, if only I had reached out sooner, but now it's too late. Now it's not too late. Now is the appointed time. And we can take the first step to apologize for our part, to let them know that we love them no matter what disagreement there was or what they did to offend us, even if we still disagree or what we did to them. There's still time let's really strive to forgive and ask God's help to bury the hatchet, to not hold on to those grudges or resentments. This is part of what our Lord means when he admonishes us that unless we become as little children, we will by no means enter the kingdom of heaven. And what can that mean? As a parent of young children, we see this sometimes, that a child may get upset, they get very upset at somebody, and even hold on to it for a little while. And yet they can also so much more easily forgive and be reconciled. Not the same child who yesterday, they got into a fight at the playground with and want nothing to do with, the next day can become a best friend. There's that openness, that willingness to be reconciled that we can strive for. We tend to, as a grown-up, mature people, we become very complicated, don't we? We have all these layers of reasons. We don't have to. Christmas especially is a time for greater simplicity. Let that simplicity enter into our hearts. And let's take this farther, too, to understand that just as we have family according to the flesh, so too do we have a spiritual family. And all of us here are brothers and sisters, not just sons and daughters of Adam and Eve, but as brothers and sisters in the body of Christ. His saving blood courses through all of our veins as we partake of the one cup. So here there must be no room for grudges and animosity towards one another. All the more through the unspeakable grace of this great feast, for the sake of the indescribable generosity of God in the gift of his Son, and following the example of his divine humility in coming down to us in our fallen state to save us. Let us resolve this Christmas to forgive, to reach out to, and to be reconciled with someone in our lives we've become estranged from. May the grace and love of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, the four feasts of his nativity we celebrate this day, unite us all in the unity of the Spirit and the bond of peace forever and ever. Amen.
Temple,
and for the pardon and remission of their sins.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray for those who bring offerings and do good works in this holy and all venerable temple, for those who labor and those who sing, and for all the people here present who await that great and rich mercy.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
For thou, O merciful God, lovest mankind, that to thee send up glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and for the ages of ages.
Praise to the Lord, the catechumens. And as the faithful pray to the catechumens, that the Lord might have mercy on them, that he may teach them the word of truth, that he may reveal to them the gospel of righteousness, that he may ornament them with his holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. Save them, have mercy on them, and also, and keep them, O God, by thy grace. Depart, let no catechumen remain. Let us, the faithful, again and again in peace, pray unto the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Wisdom.
For unto thee are due all glory, honor, and worship, unto the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Now and ever and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
Again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace of above and the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace of the whole world, for the welfare of the holy churches of God, and for the union of all, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this holy house, for those who enter with faith, reverence, and the fear of God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
That we may be delivered from all affliction, wrath, danger, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord,
on us and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Wisdom.
Our Father, and always by thy might, we send up glory to thee, to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Civil authority, those who serve in the armed forces, may the Lord God remember in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages.
All those
in the
fire,
the
fire, the truth, faith, and the hope of the resurrection, may the Lord God remember in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages. All those Christians suffering persecution for the faith throughout the world, these holy days, may the Lord God remember in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages. For all of those who are sick and suffering, all those in hospitals, nursing homes, institutions, all those who are caring for them, may the Lord God remember his kingdom, all the ones that are in the ages. The God is the benefactor of this holy house, for those who labor, for those who sing, and those who serve, for all those who have in our hearts. May the Lord God remember his kingdom, all the sound that are in the ages of ages. You, the Lord God remember his kingdom.
And all our life unto Christ our God.
To thee,
and wisdom, let us attend.
Blessed is he that comes, and I'm made of God.
lovest mankind, he also cries out and say, Holy art thou, and all holy, thou and only begotten Son of thy Holy Spirit. Holy art thou, and all holy, magnificent is thy glory. Who has so loved thy world as to give thy only begotten Son. Whoever believes in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Who, when he hath come and fulfilled all the dispensation for us, the night which is given up, or rather, gave himself up to the life of the world, took the bread in his holy, most pure, and blameless hands, and we get blessed it, we get given thanks, and blessed it, and hallowed it, and broken it, he gave it to his holy disciples and apostles, saying, Take ye, this is my body, which is broken for you, for the remission of sins.
Saints.
to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Now offered and sanctified, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
The Lord of love, thank thou, and having received him upon his holy and poetic altar above the heavens as a sweet spiritual fragrance, will send down upon us to return his divine grace and the gift of the Holy Spirit. Let us pray.
Lord, have mercy.
That we may be delivered from all affliction, wrath, danger, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
That the whole day may be perfect, holy, peaceful, and sinless, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant us, O Lord.
Faithful guide and guard of our souls and bodies, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant us, O Lord.
Pardon the remission of our sins and transgressions, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant us, O Lord.
All things that are good and profitable for our souls and peace for the world, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant us, O Lord.
That we may complete the remaining time of our life in peace and repentance, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant us, O Lord.
Take us into our life, painless, blameless, and peaceful, and a good defense before the great judgment seat of Christ, let us ask.
Grant us, O Lord. Thank you.
Christian, and she should have prepared for prayer and fasting and regular practice of confession.
Thank you.
those who trust in thee, save thy people and bless thy inheritance, preserve the fullness of thy house. Glorify them in return who put their hope in thee. Give peace to our lives. Peace to the world of my church and to my priests, to all the citizens of authority, to all the armed forces, and to all my people. For every good gift and every perfect gift is from above, coming down from the Father of lights. And unto thee we send up glory, thanksgiving, and worship unto the Father, unto the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto the ages of ages.
Okay, for many years, Father Deacon. Yes. On the 19th, Scott Thaddeus Ibrahimi has a birthday. On the 23rd, Zaza Bukhari has a birthday. On the 22nd, Leah Borowski has a names day. On the 23rd, Alexander Felicios has a names day. Patrick Eugene Odlin has a names day. On the 24th, Eugenia Lechek has a names day. John Della Monica has a birthday. Rocco Renfrey has a birthday. Anybody else?
My daughter Nicole, her birthday today.
Cool. Birthday, okay. Anybody else? Good? Grant, O Lord, a prosperous peace of life, health and salvation, furtherance in all blessed things upon thy servants, Scott, Zaza, Leah, Alexander, Patrick, Eugenia, John, Rocco, Nicole, and preserve them for many years.
Had a baby daughter, and we're still waiting on the name. It's so So I don't have the name to announce yet, but they're doing well. So thank God. Please keep Gabby and the new baby girl in your prayers. That's us this week. So please, if you can, return your pledge packets as soon as possible to help us to finalize the budget. We had our council meeting yesterday. We're about $40,000 lower than last year, but many of those. We're expecting people will pledge again, so please do encourage if you're planning to get those in so we can finalize. We don't really want to pass an unbalanced budget, so that was very helpful to get those in as soon as you can. And also just to be aware that with inflation and things that all of our expenses as a parish are going up as well. The announcement for the Nativity Fast Matching Challenge, we're almost there. In fact, I believe the last photo was we brought out $9,000 for the $10,000 match. So let's be sure to make it all the way. I know we can. And so glory to God. And I know too, we're very close to, we're several thousand more away from reaching the $100,000 goal. So if we go beyond that, we might be able to reach that as well. So let's give it one final push. Thank you all so much to everyone who has contributed. It's been another phenomenal year. As well, you can also support the Billy Growing through our coffee sales. We have a lot more last-minute Christmas gift idea. John Leslie's home-roasted Arisen coffee. Again, the proceeds go to our building program. Floral decorations are needed. We need help for nativities. You know, we have those who contribute to really making the church so beautiful for our feast days. So if you can, on Thursday, the 23rd, 8 a.m. to 9 p.m., in even an hour to help would be much appreciated. If you find out more, you can talk to Mary Cotini, and she can help direct you on what to do. The calendar of today, there's no adult class. It's a feast day for the Sonora Parish. Susanna's just keep them in your parish. Father Tom and as well as our subdeacon and reader are up with them. And Rick is a little in the weather, so no adult class today. On Tuesday, we will have our caroling, so we for those who like to join us, meet at Holy Cross at 9:30. We'll set out at 9:45. A little different this year, as you may be aware, the group home we had served for so many years for St. Xenia was sold and the residents had to go elsewhere. So we found one new group home in Rosemont area. It has less residents, but we'll get to start. So we'll try to continue this ministry more locally. We'll visit there as well as a few more parishioners. The full schedule to be determined, but if you'd like to, please do that. Miss and dressing room, most stops will be singing outside, and it could be a bit cold. And then if we do go inside, everyone should be expected to wear the masks indoors if you're coming along. Thank you, everyone, volunteer. We have enough gifts, so we do have all the gifts covered now. Thank you for that. Wednesday, we have our Vespers and Orthodox Faith and Life class. Beginning at 6 o'clock, we're starting a new book. This time we continue the Father Hopko Faith Series. We'll start Volume 4 on spirituality. So a good time to jump in or to continue with that. Friday will begin, Christmas Eve, we'll begin our Nativity cycle at 9 a.m. We'll have the Royal Hours of Nativity. The service, we're going to hear so many of the scripture readings. You hear the Psalms and the prophecies that speak of the Nativity. You hear the epistle readings that talk of it and all the gospel accounts. So as we have for Pascha in the same way, it's a very nice, very rich in scripture service. That evening, a little earlier time, so note we are serving the vigil at 4 p.m. So our Nativity vigil at 4 o'clock on Christmas Eve will be right here. And Christmas morning, Divine Liturgy, again at 9 a.m. We will not be having evening service on Christmas Day, and we'll have on the 26th Divine Liturgy at 9 a.m. once again. That's all the big announcements I have this week. There is also for the St. Nicholas Bazaar, thank you everyone who donated and helped contribute to that. We're almost to raising $500, which would be at least enough for one full scholarship or a number of partial scholarships for the summer camp. So there's a few more items for sale, but primarily olives and baked goods, I believe.
So there's one jar of olives left, and then there's some baked goods. And so baked goods are half off. I'll just be in the kitchen hall for about 20 minutes, just a little table set up. If anybody else wants to get some goodies.
So thank you. So we raised almost $500 to support our youth, and with a few more sales today, we'll hit that as well. Okay. Great. Also, welcome back to everyone who's kind of in town for the holidays or returning. But here it's good to have Gabriel back from college serving with us, and others from college. How about Valerie over there? And Sarah, welcome back from her 3 months of heart training. So good to have you back with us again. Okay. Glory to thee, our God. Glory to thee, our God. Glory to thee, our God. May the Lord bless you and have a wonderful day.